when their marriage is publicly criticized by the popular preacher, John the Baptist.
John the Baptist doesn't go along. He says, it says, according to Jewish law, you cannot marry your brother's wife while he's still alive, and I'm not giving an inch on that. John couldn't remain loyal to the Torah and to the laws of the Bible and bless Herod Antipas' marriage to his sister-in-law.
Criticized by John, Herod Antipas' plans are now in turmoil because having promised Sejanus a quiet kingdom, the last thing he now needs is a religious uprising.
We should remember that Herod Antipas, most of all, wants to be king of the Jews. Now, a very popular prophet and preacher, John the Baptist, is telling crowds of people that he's living in sin and wickedness and adultery. But if the population suddenly rises up and says no, then his whole thing will fall through. So it's not just a moral point. It's actually upsetting his whole life's project, potentially. So it's a very, very serious threat.
If you combine the sense of someone who is enormously popular, getting the crowds, with someone who could potentially criticize you, boy, you've got a problem. You had better get rid of John the Baptist.
Herod Antipas quickly arrests the troublesome John.
Herod Antipas is canny, and he's really getting rid of John before anything troubling happens, before there's a revolution.
John is imprisoned in a hilltop fortress overlooking the Dead Sea, called Machaerus.
Herod Antipas takes him across the Jordan to a desert fortress.
But with one eye on Rome, Herod Antipas is hesitant to go any further.
And I think he wants time to think. What is he going to do? Should he kill him? What if a full-scale revolt breaks out as a result of him killing him? Maybe that's not the right move. He's probably got his eye toward Rome again. What would Sejanus think? What would the emperor think? Is this the move to make?